Hi there, this is Unmesh from PiXimperfect, and today I'm going to share with you a super simple trick to make buildings look taller, much taller, with Photoshop. Now, before we get into it, we need to understand the concept behind it. You see, things look taller when we get close to it and capture it with a wide-angle lens as opposed to a telephoto lens. And here's a demonstration to show that. So have a look at this 3D cylinder, right? Now, let me change the lens to, let's say, a 200mm telephoto lens. So, I'm just going to go here and change the FOV to 200, and right here it says millimeter lens. Now, we're going to take this tool right there and slide the camera back. Hold the shift key and I'm just going to slide the camera back. Have a look. This side of the cylinder is pretty much equal to this side of the cylinder, right? Because this is a telephoto lens. The length of the cylinder is the same. Right now, if we change the FOV to a wide-angle lens, let's say an 8mm or 12mm. So let's change it to 8mm lens, okay? Now, let's get closer by holding the shift key with this tool right there. I'm just gonna drag it down. Now have a look. It's the same cylinder, but it looks much taller, way taller. Why? Because this side of the cylinder is smaller and this side of the cylinder is way larger than that. A lot of ways, but you get the point. So, to make things look taller, to make things look as if it was taken with a wide-angle lens, you need to make the things which are closer to you bigger, or make the things which is further away from you smaller, but maintaining the perspective. And this is how to do it with buildings. So first of all, we need to explain the three dimension of this building to Photoshop. And to be able to do that, we need to go to Edit. But wait, before we do any of that, we always need to have a backup and we need the ability to change the settings later. To do that, with the background layer selected, press Ctrl or Command J to make a duplicate. And you can name this, you know, Transformed or whatever you like. Now let's go to Filter and then Convert for Smart Filters and hit OK so that we can change the perspective later. Now, let's go to Edit and then Perspective Warp. The first part of Perspective Warp is telling Photoshop, explaining Photoshop how the perspective of the image is, or explaining the three dimensions of the building or the object. I'm just going to draw a rectangle right in there and just control the 4 points and take it to the 4 points of the building. So we're going to put it right there. Similarly, we're going to put this one right here. Now we can have a little bit of gap because this is a little oozed out, no problem. So we will have a little gap. Make sure we are maintaining the perspective a little bit. Let's stop right there. Now, similarly, we will follow that line and keep it in the middle, just like so. Let's go up, make sure everything is lined up properly. I'm doing it pretty fast, you can take your time and just make sure every pixel is matching. Now let's draw the second rectangle for the other side. So as soon as you draw the rectangle, one side will highlight, which means that they can snap together, join together. Release that and it just joins. Let's just go ahead and do it with this side as well. And if something doesn't work, don't worry, we can always get back. So let's do it from this side as well. Let's have a look, it works perfectly. Now that we have explained the three-dimensional structure of the building to Photoshop, we can directly go here to Warp. Now once you go to Warp, you can actually change it any way you want. In order to make it look taller, we need to make the areas which are further away smaller, right? So let's bring it closer, just like that. Don't worry about the sky, we can take care of that later. And right there, look how tall this looks at the moment. Amazing. Don't go too extreme. You might feel like going a little bit too extreme, but we can leave it at that. Now, there is a problem right there. Part of this area did not move properly. So what do? We go back to the layout, okay? And then we need to make sure that all of it is covered so that it doesn't get weird. Here, we might have to make some estimates. So I'm just going to drag it down all the way to the bottom and make sure that the 3D structure is maintained. There we are. Here as well, all the way to the bottom. Okay, now that looks nice. Now we can get back to Warp. And now it looks even better. Now there are a little bit problem here and there, but that's okay, we can fix that later. But overall, it looks perfect to me. Now once you're satisfied with this, just hit Enter or Return. Now keep in mind, You can always change the settings later by double clicking on the perspective warp. It'll just load up again. Now let's look at the image alone. Now we will turn off the background. So this is the entire image. Now you have a couple options. Option number one is, of course, you can crop it. Option number two, which is my favorite, is using content aware fill to fill up the rest of the areas. However, we would still need to crop some areas because reproducing areas like this will be difficult, but it's worth a try. It's worth a try, right? We can try it. So here's what we do. First of all, let's select the empty areas. So with the help of the tragic magic wand tool, right there, and you can keep the sample size, point sample, tolerance one. Doesn't matter now because we are selecting the empty areas. Just click once. All of the empty areas are now selected. Now, to avoid the line when you fill this area, you can just dig in a little more by going to select, modify, and then expand. You can expand it by, let's say, 5 pixels. It'll just dig in a little bit so that the line that is created, the white line, when you fill up these areas can be avoided. Once the areas are selected, we can go to edit and then content aware fill. But it is grayed out. Why? Because this, my friend, is a smart object. We need to make sure that this is rasterized before we start filling up the area. No problem at all. Just drag the layer, transform to the new layer button. A copy is created. Now we can right click on it and choose rasterize layer. This is now rasterized. Now let's go to edit and then content aware fill. I'm using the later versions of Photoshop, and in the later version, which is CC 2019 and 2020, you would get a dedicated content aware fill. Otherwise, you can go to fill and then choose content aware. So I'm just going to go to content aware fill and let's see what it does to fill up these areas. Wow, it did a pretty good job. I'm going to leave it at default. If you want to know how to play with these settings, play with all of these options, you can always check out this video. But for now, I'm just going to leave it at that because I like the default values. Just make sure that you have set the output to new layer. That way the filled area will only show up in a brand new layer, making it absolutely non-destructive. Hit OK. Have a look. Just the filled area. These are all the guest areas. As you can see, it didn't do a pretty good job, so we might have to crop a little bit from the bottom. Press C for the crop tool. You can always clear out the ratios if you already have some, and then crop it from the bottom. Now we are here. All right, there we go. It looks okay to me. Hit enter or return. Maybe we can go a little further. Just like that. Hit enter. And boom. A very tall building. Want to look at the before and after? So here is the before. And here is the after. The tall skyscraper. I hope this video helped you. Just keep in mind, the concept is when you capture it with a wide angle lens, it looks taller. Why? Because the things closer to you look much bigger than the things further away from you. The difference is kind of too much, and that difference creates that illusion. And we will take advantage of that difference to make it look taller by simply telling Photoshop about the 3D structure of the object by going to edit and then perspective warp. Just set it up and then go to warp and make the things which are further away smaller, or the things which are nearer to you larger. Anything you want, it's up to you. I hope this video helped you, and if it did, make sure to give us a like, and also don't forget to subscribe, and not just subscribe, ring the bell so that you, my friend, don't miss any other future tips, tricks, or tutorials. I would like to take this moment to thank all these nice and amazing people for supporting this channel on Patreon and helping keep PiXimperfect free for everybody forever. Thanks so much for all your support. Thank you for watching. I'll see you guys again in my next one. Till then, stay tuned and make sure that you keep creating.